It's time to move the face from the board. I'm going to use this thing that I cut my clay with. It's a plaster wall tool. I'm not sure what they call it, but it works. And I just slide it behind the head and I'm able to take the head off. Now I need to put the head someplace where I won't screw it up, and I'm going to put it right there. Okay, I got to move this out of the way. I had this thing held on to my sculpting stand with a C-clamp. Don't need that anymore today. Oh, I got a headache already and I haven't started yet. And I put this down here behind my sculpting stand out of the way. Now I need to put the sculpting stand down. This is a sculpting stand a friend of mine built me about 20, 30 years ago on a architect's adjustable stool, and he took the seat off and built a platform on the top of the where the seat went. And I just have to get it right angle to there we go. Now that works. Okay. I gotta get in here close enough to work on this. First thing I need to do is take the face off. And I'm gonna do that with an X-Acto knife and heating up the X-Acto knife. That way it'll cut through the clay a lot easier. Now I'm just going to cut right straight down. Oh, good. I was worried that my armature might be in its way, and it's not. Heat up the clay. Let's see. Can't remember how I did this. Oh, I know. And I'm using a blowtorch that I got at a local gas station, actually. Oh, it's perfect size, too. Oh, I was worried about that. All right. So it kind of looks kind of odd with just the face on there, but it's all going to work out eventually. I think I got the face too far forward. I'm going to take it off and try it again. Oh, first you gotta cut off more clay. I think I'm gonna use a different tool. I think I'm gonna use this one to cut off more clay. There we go. Now, see if I got too much taken off. If I do, I just add more clay back on. Melt the clay so that the clay face will stick to the clay much better. Yeah, that's going to work. Now, how long is her neck? Is her neck long? Yeah, it's pretty long. Yes, it is. She's got a long neck. All right. Now I'm ready to start adding clay. I'm happy with the way this face turned out. I'll still work on it a little bit, but after I get more into it and see how much of the face is going to be showing. All right, let's get these tools out of the way. And let's put that right there. I gotta let the clay soften, so I'm gonna come back in about a half hour or so. Well, after working on the Viking and this piece, I've gotten some messy tools that need to be clean. The only way to clean them is with a little heat. So I'm glad, and I need to clean this table off so I can find things, which I found hard to do. I just found this tool just now that I was looking for the other day. Oh, man. So anyway, that's what I'm doing right now while I'm waiting for my clay to soften up. I'm making use of my time. This is a tool every artist who does sculpture or painting needs, and it's a caliper, set of calipers. You can measure and make sure your measurements are correct on your proportions and things like that. I'm going to put that over there. Now, I got my glyptic tools here, and the neat thing about these is if you don't have a use for a particular head on the tool, you can change it out. And I got me a little plastic container that I can put the different heads in. Hold on a second. All right, I'm just loosening up the Allen screw, and now I'm taking out the head, and I'm going to put it there. And then I've got another tool that has a small head on the end of it, this one here. And I want to put it on the smaller handle instead of this big handle. Let me see if I can get it close to the camera. I'm trying to see at a weird angle here whether I got my... But that I just traded out that square head with this small tool. All right, take this heat, this flame, and just hit the tool, and that gets all the clay off of it and all the wax or old clay. It just makes it easier to handle your tool after you've cleaned it. Sorry, I can't see my camera, and I can't see if it's in picture or not. There we go. So I'll just continue cleaning my tools. You don't want to touch the end of your hit with a flame too soon after you hit it with a flame, because you go, ouch. All right, I don't need that tool for now. I'm just going to hit the tools that I need. That was one I might new use. I'll tell you, the tools an artist uses have a lot to do with the quality of his work. You got good tools, you're going to have good quality art. You don't, well, you'll struggle. That's why tools are very important. A painter will always get the best paint brushes they can afford. And they got to replace them a lot. Well, I'm back and had my dinner. Made a chicken fried steak. probably about the 20th one I've made for myself. The first one I ever made was terrible. This one wasn't bad, it just wasn't great. And because I didn't do it like I should. I never do anything once or again like I should. I try to always do something a little different. This chicken fried steak, I learned something. If you want to make the gravy, use fresh milk or fresh buttermilk. I like buttermilk in it because it gives that real nice flavor. But I use the same milk I dipped my steak in, which is not bad. The only problem is I used egg in the dip, and because I did, and when I tried to make gravy using that milk, being fastidious with my milk, because I want to make another chicken fried steak later on this week, found out that making it with the milk you dip your steak in, with egg all beat up in it, well, the egg turns into an egg turns into a scrambled egg in the milk. And so you put the oil in the pan, you take the milk, or you take the flour and you throw it in there, and you get it all smooth and unlumpy, and then you put the milk in and it becomes coagulated because of the egg. It was still good and flavorful, but a little too thick. And the more milk I added, the more egg got in. So so I think I learned a lesson today on cooking chicken fried steak and making gravy. I tell you, last year this time I couldn't have made gravy. I didn't even know how to make gravy. But I've learned, taught myself. Now the house and therefore my studio has this delightful smell of a fried chicken fried steak. Can't complain. All right, what I'm doing right now is forming the head as best I can. The shape. It's going to be covered by a hat and a head of hair, but I did want to get that going. And she has some rather high trapezius muscle. I think I got the head too, or the neck too long, so I need to take out a little bit of the neck. And I'll do that with my knife, if I can tell you what I did with it. What did I do with my knife? Oh, there it is. I'm doing this video in real time so that you get the feel of being in my studio. A lot of you express the desire to sit with me, so you are today. And now I'm looking for my lighter. There it is. It makes it hard lighting a lighter because my thumb is numb and this finger is numb and it hurts. But I'll survive. A little painful, but that's okay. You get to be 72. You get used to getting a little bit of pain here and there. And a lot of discomfort. I'm going to take about quarter, about a quarter of an inch out of her neck. And I made the armature for the head out of the wire that I used for the arms and that. And I just used a single wire that I pushed down into the body, so now I could just basically, I don't want to go too low. There we go. Much better. Push the head more in the center of the body. Yeah. I'm trying to imitate what I see in the photograph of her and imitate the muscles in her neck. Her shirt is a low cut shirt that comes down about right here. It's kind of like a t-shirt with frilly sleeves on it. I kind of like it. And put the muscle of the neck in there. Looks like in the picture. Don't want too big a muscle. There we go. Yeah, that looks good. Some other pictures here. This is the picture I'm going by here. Looking at profile to see how underneath her chin looks. Why I wanted to get the head on the armature so I can make the face interact with the neck of the figure. too big. Before I can put clothes on, I gotta have the body under the clothes. And key is make both sides the same size. There we go. Now she's got a strap from her backpack that goes down here, so that's going to distort that just a little. Same with this side too. Nope, I need her neck just a little longer and her head out just a little bit more. That's better. Hair comes down to about that length, and it's over and behind her ears. I just want to see how it looks. And she wears her hair kind of behind her ear, but the hat will make that a little different too. She is in her, I think, 40s or 50s, I'm not certain. So this anatomy is going to be just a little different than a young person. And let's see what her shoulder width looks like. Yeah, she's got pretty good sized shoulders. I'm gonna come back tomorrow. The clay is getting hard. My hand is hurting because of numbness, and I'm going to come back when my clay is a little softer. But I think you can see how I'm just sort of blocking in the form of the female without going into great detail, because it's going to all be covered with clothes and backpack anyway. But you still have to have that form underneath. All right. Next time. Yeah, I'm going to let it sit overnight, and then I'll come back and see how I feel about the figure, and I'll work on it some more. Give me a thumbs up and share my video. And then check out my instructional DVDs, the link down below this video. All right, see you next time.